I want to talk about something people are really excited about. That's artificial intelligence. Greg, we recently reported that just about a week ago, exactly a week ago, Bridgewater started its own AI strategy in a new format here, a new fund format. But also, you were an early investor in OpenAI, in Anthropic. How do you think about investing in AI at Bridgewater? Do you buy into those high-flying names, or are you better off doing it in the private names personally, given where valuations are today?
Yeah, well, I'd say when we think about it from a pure alpha perspective, most of what we built up at Bridgewater is an expert system based on everything we've learned over the 40 years, mainly on how economic cycles work. And big productivity miracles are pretty separate from economic cycles. So when you look at what we're doing in pure alpha, we're generally trying to make sure we don't have too much exposure to whether the productivity miracle works out or not. So when we trade U.S. equities, we trade them kind of with AI hedged, because the pressures, the normal cyclical pressures will play out on the regular companies. And when you look at US stocks, it's kind of the regular companies that we'd say are pretty expensive relative to the rest of the world. Mediocre companies in the US have a US premium in them relative to the rest of the world. Now, the great companies in the US are the companies hitting the cutting edge. That's a different story. And it's very different than 1999, 2000. I've been at Bridgewater for 29 years and having lived through 99, 2000. That bubble was all about future expectations. Most of what's priced into equities today actually would say are based on what's happening right now. I mean, what's happening with NVIDIA's demand is incredible. And whether it's slightly overpriced or slightly underpriced or whatever, it's a close call. This is not like the 99 bubble, at least in my view, because the earnings for those companies are actually there in a way they weren't there for a company like Cisco in 1999. So there is a big difference. Now, you still need those earnings to be sustainable, which requires a continued growth in those areas, but not an outlandish one. And that really comes to what internally. So we need to understand AI from a macro perspective, and then we need to understand it from a micro perspective, right? That in our AI labs, which is 25 people we set aside at Bridgewater, fully focused on using machine learning for everything you need to do to invest in markets, that group, we're hands-on. We see both the problems. There are many problems. The language models off the shelf have many problems with them. But if you can combine them with data models, you can create this incredible strength. And right now, I expect over the next 5 years, so much of what human investors and analysts can be better done with machine intelligence. So that's been a journey for me. I've been looking at this for, Bridgewater's built an expert system based on human intuition being translated into algorithms.
Right.
For AI, having machine learning generate the ideas, generate the algorithms. That's been kind of a dream for me. And the technologies really came together in 2022 or so, that the pieces came together such that I thought we were ready to build an artificial investor. And we've moved down that track at rapid rate.